Greetings, ladies and gentlemen. I am ShadowBlazer 3000. I have a new thing to unpackage for you. It's a big box, as you can see. Got something real special in the mail today. Let's open it up and find out. Alright, there we go. Got her open. Oh, there's a lot of junk. Oh, what's this, actually? I need to wrap this in like six letters of... Oh, actually it's a two in one. Oh, that's right, I forgot to ship this. It's not just this, that's why it's so big. I was like, why is it so big? I didn't think it was that big, but... for one, I got Urara Mericho, Mericho, whatever it's called, Mericho. It was called Maztown Book for a bit by the English, as the English titles go, but... They decided not to call it. This is from last winter. It's a pretty cute show. I liked it. You know, it's Sentai Filmworks, sub only, but oh well. It looks more fan service-y than it is, trust me. There's really not that much fan service in it. Cute show though, really liked it. But that's not the only thing I got. That's just a two-in-one bonus here. What I really got, what I really got is something super special awesome. Let's get rid of it. Yeah, there we go. You can see it already. This, this is kind of a repeat, right? This is the real deluxe edition for Flip Flappers. Now, you already know, I own the standard Bluray. Hold on, I got it somewhere. I thought the special edition had come out the same time as the standard Bluray, but it actually came out just about like a week ago or two. So I decided to hold off on ordering it until recently, until there's actually a pretty good Sentai Filmworks sale. I got 40% off. Oh, it's very pretty, you can see. Look at that. That is big. Comes with all sorts of really great, interesting stuff inside. You're lucky I like this show so much. I know, I don't... a bit of a double dip, but I really like the show. Even if it's... I mean, it is in my top 20, after all. But I really like the show, and of course, always want to support good original product when you can. Everywhere you can, any way you can. There's only so much I can do, though. And that's how I saved the anime industry. Not really. I mean, 3Hertz has got another product out this year. I thought they were just going to be relegated to working on the Sao spinoff, and I don't know if it'll be good or not, but... So, hey, Studio 3Hertz isn't hurting, but... you know, just going off the Oricon charts, this show did pretty poorly. Kind of tanked in sales in Japan. But again, that's based purely on Oricon charts, and those charts are very limited in their scope. So let's pull it out. You've already seen the Bluray. It's the same Bluray, it just comes with a fancy... Oh, this actually has a nice flat case, jewel case. Why can't Sentai put these out? I don't think it's a hybrid pack, is it? I don't know what else it would have. We'll get to that book in a sec. Oh, it has this. Goodness. I think these are like postage cards or whatever. Flip flap. Oh, it's a bookmark. Oh, I like it. Oh. This is some fancy stuff. This is what unboxings are all about. Can you see it very well? This isn't the greatest camera. I need to buy a new one soon, but I need more hours. Cute little bookmark. What do we got here? We got the two discs. Personally, don't recommend the English dub for this one. I really don't. I don't think the character voices are fitting in the slightest. Even though they have some pretty good casting, it's just the directing's poor on it. So I'm going to say stick subtitles. With this series, it's much better in Japanese. So... just as a quick, yeah, Lucy Christian as Coconut, Brittany Karbowski as Paprika. Would have flipped him personally, and either way, I don't like the way Lucy plays Coconut, I don't like the way Brittany plays Paprika. Can't. You got Yaya Kash, she sounded okay. the twins, Toto and Yu Yu. Just from the viewfinder, his hair looked like really weird, but it's just how it is. They made his voice really deep in the dub, even though he's supposed to be like a really young kid, so I don't know why they did that. But I'm not here to complain about the dub. I got a reversible cover. Oh, cute! let's compare it to the other Blu-ray for a bit, shall we? So this is the back of the standard Blu-ray. Put that down for a sec. A little fantasy never hurt anyone, but pure illusion can be deadly. You know, you got your standard screenshots. This actually features their little ending versions, how they appear in the ending. 3Hertz always has really creative ending animations, or at least of the shows I've seen out of them. I mean, this, Princess Principal, really looking forward to see what they come out with next. I hope they kind of keep that. I hope they kind of make that their studio signature, is really unique looking ending themes. Of course, you got the full episode listing, which is nice. Pure illusion. Next, pure audio. I don't think this does, actually. Does it? No. Ah, just toss that down there. So you got pure input, pure converter, pure XLR. Of the Magus variety. No, I'm kidding. Pure equalization. Pure echo with the creepy ghost girls. Still creepy. Pure play. Pure component. Got a little Yuri teasing going on. Ooh. pure breaker. Pure mute. A little spoilerish too, but if you got the Blu-ray, you probably have seen this at a lot of this at this point. Pure jitter. Pure storage, pure Howley, pure audio, of course features master audio 2.0, blah blah blah, the usual stuff. So that's the Blu-ray. I think it's a Blu-ray, yeah. Be a little weird if it was a DVD. Yeah, it's Blu-ray. Maybe? Yeah, they're both Blu-rays. Okay, I'm like, I did, sometimes, you know, Funimation still does like the two for two, but I have heard Sentai's working to phase out their DVDs and go pure Blu-ray. Another pure. Now let's take a look at the book. I think it's just a standard art book. I've never been a huge fan of art books because they always usually amount to just being screenshots from the anime. Oh, it's even better than that. We got storyboards, yo! Studio 3Hertz. Into the sky, I guess. Wow, we got storyboards for probably every episode. Yeah, look at that. Got the opening, of course. I'm not a huge fan of the opening theme. It's just kind of generic. I say as I hum it. Now what do we got? We got... Oh, I got some staff notes. I really... From the director... Kiyotaka Oshima. I really wanted Kojima to do the key... I don't think that's Hideo Kojima, by the way. To do the key animation for the opening theme as well. But he wasn't available at this time, so I had to tearfully hand-draw it over... Over to the other animation director. Another. Kojima, I'm guessing it's the character designer. I wanted to draw the key animation too, but in the... And I edited and touched up what the key animation guys put out. Interesting. Let's see if there's any other comments going back for a bit. Oh yeah, there's comments on every page. There's kind of like introductory comments. Dude. it might just be like director notes for every single storyboard of each episode. But I won't go through them all. You should get the book for yourself. Of course, you see all the variations of Hapika from that one episode. More director comments, of course. Just about who all these personas are. Got some coconut art. There's Chibi Coconut. That's from episode 6. That's the really kind of cerebral episode where they keep switching back and forth with each other in the mind of their senpai who... Yeah, great episode. Of course you got Yayaka. I like this. This is really cute when she's got her hair in like these braids. These little pig twin tail braids here. These are... And that little school uniform. That is really cute. That's a fun episode, but it is kind of creepy. Got the weird succubus from the Mad Max world. From the Mad Max world of the madness. I'm sorry to do this all like one-handed. And you got TT392 Boo-chan, of course, as he's called. A lot of great comments. I'm gonna have to pour through these. Jeez. Yeah, Dr. Salt. Yuke's Kuel. There's one good thing for the dub. You kind of learn how to finally say this damn thing's name. It's like, it's a rabbit, but it's not a rabbit. What does the director have to actually say about it? By adding a few different elements to a basic rabbit, I was able to expand the real world, quote unquote, of flip-flappers. If a creature like this could exist normally in that world, I wanted to make sure I introduced it right from the get-go. We didn't make Yuxkuel I'm reading this right off my viewfinder because I'm afraid if I jerk my head or something, I'm going to pull it out of focus. And of course, character designers. Osamu Danzai was our model for Salt. I was asked to give him a tired, worn-out look. Got young Salt at age 14. At age 19. Hidaka. And you got Sayuri. You got Toto. The twins. Let's see. I wanted to draw Toto with rounded eyebrows, and I gave him the shortest shorts possible. Hey, you're not wearing shorts. Everyone knows they're comfy and easy to wear. He's a child of Amorphorus, so he inherited some of Mimi's coloration. Yayaka, god damn it, focus, and Yuyu fight on the front line, so we had Toto use ranged weapons from a distance and fight with his intellect. Also, many of our artists are especially good at drawing missiles, which is why we chose those for Toto. Of course, you got Yuyu. Having Yuyu's veins halfway covering her eyes was Mr. Oshiyama's idea, as was the cast. There's a face drawn on front of it, so we thought about having it changed here and there, too. Since Yayaka's speed is her best offense, we made Yuyu her arm. Okay. Of course, you got Mimi. Mimi, age 14. We thought to make Mimi the most beautiful character of the show. She is a girl with unbelievable amount of power, shrouded in mystery. We wanted to give her the impression of a naive doll-like beauty kept in a box far away from the real world, and I ink, we come pretty close to that, since she and Coconut are directly related. Spoiler alert there, but again, if you probably already watched the show if you have the Blu-ray. We used Coconut's facial parts for her as well, with a few minor adjustments. Baby Coconut! Mimi has blue hair and red eyes, but Coconut has blue hair and brown eyes. Yeah, she has her father's eyes. Toto Yuyu and Niu Niu all have some light blue hair and brown eyes. Children born with Mimi's bloodline through the power. Oh, so that's kind of explains it. They don't really explain who and what Toto and Yuyu are. So I guess they are kind of like clones of Mimi, so to speak. Let's see. Mimi transformation. I like to call her the... Sorry, out of frame. I like to call her the Nega Mimi. But this really goes into quite a bit of detail here. It's not just the usual art book. You know what? I got a good example. Give me a sec. Contrast, let's look at this. This is the quote-unquote art book of Cardcaptor Sakura. This came with the Blu-ray for the first re-release. As you can see, it's just a lot of screenshots. And it's... just episode synopsises. Kind of boring, right? I mean, you can get screenshots online, you can capture them right from your Blu-ray. It's not like it's a hard thing to get screenshots. So, now compare it again back to this, which is actual, like, in-depth production details, sketches, and that, and comments and notes. This is worth it. This is definitely worth it. Hey, it's the mech! And just some other details for the streetcar and that. Just a lot of, like, basic things. Definitely for art students, for animation enthusiasts, for people who want to, like, draw and actually animate, great stuff for you. Got the salt father. Father of salt. He's a salty father. Oh, I'll stop there. That's weird, Coconut, that weird t-shirt. And of course, them in the winter uniforms, which I like at the end. That's cute. I like the winter, like, sailor uniform. That's such a cute uniform. Of course, you got Transformation Paprika. You got Second Transformation Paprika. And Coconut, of course, when they go fairy mode. Injured Yayaka. Now you got some more sketches, some key art. More storyboards. Now you got the Iridori episode. More storyboards, more... Well, there's Mimi with her baby, with Coconut. There's Yayaka's transformation. We're not gonna get the full color of that. Now we got some concept art. See, concept art's interesting because it's generally the pre-visualization stuff. It's before everything's finalized and committed to film. Oh, what's this? This isn't in the anime. That's why I said it's concept art. I wonder what this is. Who might this be? This is not a character. Maybe an early concept for Coconut? Maybe a different concept for transformation? Who knows? Interesting. And of course, now you got some basics. But more notes. But it's got notes. So this is probably some comments on the art direction about the background art. More art. More concept art. There's little Coconut! These are really nice looking. The city of the future. The negative space, basically, that where nothing existed. That was a pretty weird place. There's Mimi again. More comments. And that's it. I mean, that's the gist of the book here. So overall, really great. This is way impressive. This is more impressive than I even thought I'd be. I mean, this is a pretty pricey set. It cost me about $90. I mean, it was like $89.99 because you get free shipping through Econo shipping with Right Stuff. But it's a little pricey, but if you're a huge fan of the show like I am, I'd say it's definitely worth it. So if not, if you like the show but you don't need all the bells and whistles, then of course the standard Blu-ray will do you just fine. Either way, I'm happy to have this now as part of my illustrious collection. Along with this, I wish this was a freebie that they threw in. It's not. I bought this too. But the real highlight, of course, the big Flip Flappers box set. Definitely worth the money. I'm glad I spent it. Glad I bought it. Excellent show. Excellent quality. Excellent value. Good on you, Sentai Filmworks, for putting out a really awesome set. There you go. There's the side. Yeah. Thanks for watching.